I was focusing on methods of motion capture for animals, specifically dogs. For humans, it's straightforward just to put them in a motion capture suit. My work then was about how can we figure out the best way just to motion capture animals without the motion capture suits. Because a lot of my research involved collecting this data set, because that didn't exist beforehand, now that we have the data set, there's a lot of kind of potential directions that we could go in now using this data. As the technology progresses, you see more computer generated animals in TV shows and games and stuff like that. But there's also applications where people are looking into kind of how to detect maybe lameness in horses, or kind of maybe integration with the sporting industry, how to improve performance for maybe race horses or for show jumping horses. But also from a kind of scientific point of view, there's a lot of things we can learn from animals. Google is creating these dog-like robots at the moment, and they're using motion capture from dogs to help train the robots to move across terrain and things like that. So yeah, there's a lot of possible kind of directions you could go with this research. A vet could easily have it set up. Maybe there's things like dogs being fit with prosthetic legs. You could even track, like, as the dog is healing across time, you could record the dog with the camera and then analyze data on your laptop.